Championship, scheduled for one fall. Coming down the aisle, Red Lions manager, from out of the South, Colonel Jimmy Hart, from Memphis, Tennessee, weighing 248 pounds, the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, the Honky Tonk Man.
Is he an entertainer? Hi, Alfred.
Oh, he's something else.
You're right, Bobby. He's
my favorite, one of my favorite singers and dancers.
He really does a good job with that particular air.
And his opponent and challenger about to come down towards the ring, led by his manager, Oliver Humperdinck, from Asbury Park, New Jersey, weighing 393 pounds, Bam Bam Bigelow.
Hello, everybody. This is Lord Alfred Hayes, ringside in New Haven, with my colleague of the hour, Bobby the Brain Heenan. Bobby, what do you think of this huge, colossal man here, who is so light and so nimble on his feet? Bam Bam Bigelow.
Well, you're right about that. He's very agile, but he's got a very bad choice and very bad taste in managers.
Well,
Oliver Humperdinck is going to do nothing but get you in trouble.
Well, he's got a very colorful jacket, I know that.
It looks like he fell off a deck of cards.
And Honky Tonk Man there, I don't think he's all that satisfied with his fan reception here, Bobby.
Well, you know, they're very jealous of him. Everybody out there, those guys sitting in those white t-shirts with their ugly girlfriends while they're swooning, you know, those guys are jealous because they can't dance and they can't play and they can't wrestle and they're not the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion.
Whoa, look at Bigelow chasing him out the ring. You got to take your hat off to Honky Tonk. He's not turned down any challenges for that Intercontinental title. And Bam Bam is certainly one of the toughest he's going to have to face.
Do you ever think of wearing your hair like that, Alfred?
No, I've never ever given that a thought.
Never ever?
You mean the one with the tattoo or the other?
Doesn't matter.
Jimmy Hart, his manager there, Malthus Elf, giving a few words of advice and maybe encouragement at the same time, and carrying that dreaded instrument there, the megaphone, with him.
Well, you know what's good about the Honky Tonk Man is, you know, he's setting the pace here. He's the one dictating the time. He's going in, he's going out. And it seems like Bigelow's getting nervous.
Well, if this is the pace he's setting, it's going to last for a few hours. There's been no actual physical contact yet.
See,
although it looks like Bam Bam is about to finish that.
Now watch, he'll roll in and get stopped here. Uh-oh, no, I was wrong.
Oh, look at those tremendous blows from that huge arm of Bam Bam Bigelow. Great back elbow. Oh, he's really on fire, Bigelow.
You know what he looks like to me in that black with all the flames? Looks like one of those big garbage dumpsters on fire.
Well, I would refrain from comments like that if I were you while he was around, Bobby.
Oh! Oh,
a tremendous forearm.
It'd be nice if your daughter brought him home and said, Mommy, Daddy, I want you to meet Mr. Wright.
Well, he just might be Mr. Wright.
Well, one good thing about him, though, Alfred, you know, when you're on a date with him, if you get bored, you can always read him.
Nice arm hold there by Bigelow. And so far, this match has been all Bam Bam Bigelow. And this championship is at stake. We could see history in the making here.
That's right. You know, I thought Honky Tonk was going to set the pace. Well, maybe he still is.
Not as of yet.
We on? What?
Yeah, we're on.
Well, I don't know where this goof went. He's outside doing something. He took the papers with him, or I'd have it down. I usually have my sheet here in front of me, but we're gonna.
Bobby, go.
Don't tell me what to do. I know we're on. Just looking for my papers here. Well, the only thing I can come up with now is, Bam Bam looks like he's in a little trouble. Honky Tonk is taking it to him. We're going back to Alfred and me, and I'm going to find the gorilla someplace.
Bam Bam still pressing home his advantage here. So far, it's been all Bam Bam, and Honky Tonk hasn't figured in this title defense one iota.
But have you noticed both the managers are pacing constantly?
Bam Bam now beginning to measure his man and take his time, sinking a heavy knee and trying to put that head to the shoulder. I do believe he missed that shot.
You know, for a man his size, you must admit he hasn't stopped. He's kept going. I'm surprised the guy's not out of gas.
He seems to be taking his time, and this is a high-risk movement for
Look
such
that.
A big man. Oh, he was airborne then. And now, for the first time, we see an offensive move by Honky Tonk Man. And maybe he was playing possum for quite a while there.
Boy, with all those flames, the way he was coming down, he was like the Hindenburg.
Wow. He landed very heavily. You might be right there. The Honky Tonk Man is now getting a little cool, a little cocky, and very clever.
Well, I know Humperdinck is giving some instructions. That won't help.
Bam Bam, after that catastrophic miss, is tremendously slow, but still possessing a lot of power and a lot of strength, but those legs look as if they're buckling to me.
He went for that shake, rattle, and roll, didn't he? Seems like the referee doesn't want to get close to Bam Bam. Maybe he has an air about him.
If he gets too close, Bam Bam will crush him like a little fly. Ah, straight through the ropes and out onto the floor. But fortunately for the champion, he's landed on his feet, but he doesn't know Bam Bam's behind him. Bam Bam taking and ramming that shoulder inside of his face into the steel post. And now Honky Tonk is taking quite a pounding here from the big man.
Doesn't seem to be doing too much damage to him, though.
Oh, there's his flying leap there. And the referee is stopping. I'm not quite sure why.
Why? Has he disqualified him?
I'm not quite sure.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is the referee's official decision. He awards the bout as a result of a countout to the man who is...